Blessed be the God of our salvation. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the high and lofty one who inhabits eternity, whose name is holy. Shout out, do not hold back. Lift up your voice like a trumpet. Announce to my people their rebellion, to the house of Jacob their sins. Yet day after day they seek me and delight to know my ways, as if they were a nation that practiced righteousness and did not forsake the ordinance of their God. They ask of me righteous judgments. They delight to draw near to God. Why do we fast, but you do not see? Why humble ourselves, but you will not notice? Look, you serve your own interest on your fast day and oppress all your workers. Look, you fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness and your gloom be like the noonday. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places and make your bones strong. And you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose waters never fail. Your ancient ruin shall be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundations of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of streets to live in. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the second letter to the Corinthians. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteous of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying and see, we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Lord, Lord.
Jesus said, "Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." The Gospel of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Tonight in the world, we celebrate love. We bring flowers and gifts to those we love, and we enjoy time together to bring to mind everything that binds us together. Today, also in the church, we celebrate love. But this is a love that lasts forever, spanning across time from the beginning until now, and it's better than diamonds. This is the love that gathered dust together and molded it in their hands, breathing and infusing life into it. This is the love that is with us. This is the love of God, which never ends. On this night, we take time together to remember what binds us, the life that we have, the love we have been given, but also to acknowledge that this life we have will end, but the love we have from God never does. It is a wonderful convergence of events, Ash Wednesday and Valentine's Day, because ultimately, this day, inside and out of the church, outside of the church, as I've said several times now, is all about love. It's about the love that holds us when we cannot stand, or the love that forgives us when we fail, the love that welcomes us home when we have strayed, the love that endures when we cannot. In just a few moments, we will acknowledge all the things that we do that keep us from this love, and we will smudge ash on our foreheads and bear the marks of our mortality in the shape of a cross. This cross represents death. It represents the violence that we cannot seem to get enough of, the deepest and darkest parts of ourselves, the sting of loss, and the bitter pain of grief. But this cross also represents love, and the enduring love of God, who is purely, steadfastly, and abundantly love. This cross leads to Jesus, who through his death leads us to life and turns our eyes to see that though we are dying, in Jesus we are alive. When we baptize people, we mark their heads with oil and the sign of the cross. And when people are dying, we make that same cross on their heads, marking them both as Christ's own forever. This cross joins us forever with that divine. Our first steps through every moment of our lives and even at the end. And so we make this mark today in the sign of a cross to remind us that we belong, to draw our attention to our journey of faith, to prepare ourselves for our inevitable death, and to join us to the full meaning of that cross and all that we find there. Tonight we remember that we are dust, the same dust drawn together in the beginning to create the spark of light in the darkness, the same dust that blew over the earth to bring life from the waters and the dirt and the green growing grasses, the same dust that formed us in God's hand and breathed into us and filled us with the Spirit, who touched our hearts so that they would pulse with Jesus' love. The same dust that collected between Jesus' toes and clung to the eyelashes of the disciples. The same dust that sticks to the tear-stained cheeks of all who grieve. The dust that collects in our throats as we yearn for justice, for goodness, and for everlasting love. The dust that finds our way to our forehead tonight. That dust points to what survives when everything else is gone. It reminds us of what binds us together, which is God. Remember, you are dust, and to dust you will return. It is not only the darkness of the cross, it is the light breaking forth like the dawn. The promise of all that we find there. It is not simply a recognition of our mortality. It is the promise that the love of God is eternal and can never be taken away. This is why we come here tonight, to celebrate love in this place, on this day, binding ourselves to a love that cannot fade, but only endures, holding fast to the promise of the cross. We join together on this day in this place to remember that though we are dust, we will return to the Lord who made us out of dust in the first place, and to the gracious, abundant, and never-ending love that we will always find there. Amen. And as you're able to continue with me in the bulletin on page 8. Dear people of God, the first Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection, and it became the custom of the church to prepare for them by a season of penitence and fasting. This season of Lent provided a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. It was also a time when those who, because of notorious sin, had been separated from the body of the faithful, were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness and restored to the fellowship of the church. Thereby, the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution set forth in the gospel of our Savior and the need which all Christians continually have to renew their repentance and faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the church, to the observance of a holy Lent, by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word. And to make a right beginning of repentance, and as a mark of our mortal nature, let us now kneel before the Lord, our Maker and Redeemer. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be to us a sign of our mortality and penitence, that we may remember that it is only by your gracious gift that we are given everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. You're invited at this time to come forward to the altar rail to receive the imposition of ashes.
Thank you.
most holy and merciful Father, we confess to you. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven.
We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit.
We confess to you, Lord, all our past unfaithfulness, the pride, hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives.
Our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people.
Our anger at our own frustration, and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves.
Our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts, and our dishonesty in daily life and work.
Our negligence in prayer and worship, and our failure to commend the faith that is in us.
Accept our repentance, Lord, for the wrongs we have done, for our blindness to human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty.
For all false judgments, for uncharitable thoughts towards our neighbors, and for our prejudice and contempt toward those who differ from us.
For our waste and pollution of your creation and our lack of concern for those who come after us.
Restore us, good Lord, and let your anger depart from us.
Accomplish in us the work of your salvation.
By the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord,
Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desires not the death of sinners, but rather that they may turn from their wickedness and live, has given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardons and absolves all those who truly repent and with sincere hearts believe his holy gospel. Therefore, we beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do on this day, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Continue with the service of Holy Communion. All are welcome at the table. Just follow the usher's instructions and come forward. If you prefer a gluten-free wafer, please let us know. And if you prefer to have communion in your seat today, please let us know and we're happy to bring it to you. I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercy of God, to present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and good and joyful to give you thanks. All holy God, source of life and fountain of mercy, you bid your faithful people cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that fervent in prayer and in works of mercy, and renewed by your word and sacraments, they may come to the fullness of grace which you have prepared for those who love you. Therefore, joining with angels and archangels, and with the faithful of every generation, we lift our voices with all creation as we sing. Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of the universe and giver of life. You formed us in your own image and called us to dwell in your infinite love. You gave the world into our care that we might be your faithful stewards and show forth your bountiful grace. But we failed to honor your image in one another and in ourselves. We would not see your goodness in the world around us. And so we violated your creation, abused one another, and rejected your love. Yet you never ceased to care for us, and you prepared the way of salvation for all people. Through Abraham and Sarah, you called us into covenant with you. You delivered us from slavery, sustained us in the wilderness, and raised up prophets to renew your promise of salvation. Then, in the fullness of time, you sent your eternal word, made mortal flesh in Jesus. Born into the human family and dwelling among us, he revealed your glory. Giving himself freely to death on the cross, he triumphed over evil, opening the way of freedom and life. On the night before he died for us, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Remembering his death and resurrection, we now present to you from your creation this bread and this wine. By your Holy Spirit, may they be for us the body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ. Grant that we who share these gifts may be filled with the Holy Spirit and live as Christ's body in the world. Bring us into the everlasting heritage of your daughters and sons, that with all your saints, past, present, and yet to come, we may praise your name forever. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us. Live without fear. Your Creator has made you holy, has always protected you, and loves you. Go in peace to follow the good road, and may God's blessing be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.